Tyaga. In any level, whether you give up one meal or you give up whatever you call as wealth, anything you give up, from the context that you are Paramashiva, understand that. The context from which, the cognition from which you decide to do tyaga is too important. Cognition that you are Paramashiva, with that, any tyaga you do, you start infusing yourself with Paramashiva Prana, you become Bhairava, Mahabhairava, Mahakala Bhairava. Understand? Like how, if you fill the balloon with helium gas, it goes up. If you fill yourself with the Prana of Paramashiva through Tyaga, you just go to Kailasa. Mahakala Bhairava is Lord of Tyaga, Tyaga Raja, Paramashiva. When he manifests his Tyaga dimension, he is worshipped as Mahakala Bhairava. Kala Bhairava never punishes, he only helps you to achieve Paramashivatva. For example, even that Brahma story. If Kala Bhairava is angry, he would have killed Brahma. Brahma is nobody for Kala Bhairava. But he did not kill Brahma. He just removed the ego, which stops Brahma to see the ultimate reality, which stops Brahma to see his Paramashivatva. Only that path he removed. Means Kala Bhairava actually helped Brahma to achieve his ultimate state eternally. That's why Brahma remains as devotee for Kala Bhairava. Some fools try to tell, oh, Brahma was punished by Kala Bhairava. No. He only removes the ego and enlightens. Kala Bhairava is absolute compassion, eternally sweet, cute, absolute compassion. As I said, you can tickle his hip when you see him. He will laugh. He's too cute. To hide that cuteness, he stands ferocious. Hey! Hey! But he's too sweet. He's only interested in your enlightenment. He removes only what need to be removed. The ultimate Tyagi, Paramashiva, Tyagaraja.